This chapter will familiarize you with how to tune the three-term controllers of a viscosity system. The proportional feedback control can reduce error response to disturbances, but it still allows a non-zero steady-state error. When the controller includes a term proportional to the integral of the error, then the steady-state error can be eliminated, although this comes at the expense of further deterioration in the dynamic response. Finally, addition of a term proportional to the derivative of the error can dampen the dynamic response. Combined, these three kinds of controls make the classic PID controller. Some commonly used technical terms are set point, deviation, proportional controller gain, P-action, proportional band, integral controller action, I-action, derivative controller action, D-action. The set point, or desired value, is the value of the controlled variable that is desired to maintain. The deviation is the difference at any time between the controlled variable or measured value and the set point. The proportional controller gain is the amplification factor of a controller, a linear relation. The proportional band is the range of scale values through which the controlled variable must pass in order that the final control element is moved through its entire range. The integral controller action is when there is a relation between an integral function of the controlled variable during the rise time, TR, and the position of a final control element. The derivative controller action is when there is a predetermined relation between a derivative function of the controlled variable and the position of a final control element. For control over steady state and transient errors, we can combine all three control strategies to get proportional integral derivative control. Here, the control signal is a linear combination of the error, the time integral of the error, and the time rate of change of the error. All three gain constants are adjustable. The PID combination is sometimes able to provide an acceptable degree of error reduction simultaneously with acceptable stability and damping. PID controllers are so effective that PID control is standard in such processing industries as petroleum refining, papermaking, and metalworking. For tuning a fuel oil viscosity control system of a main engine, two methods are available. 1. Fine-tuning the different settings of the controller and looking at the results. 2. Continuous cycling method. Find out what kind of controller you have, whether it is a P, PI, or PID, and start with the fine-tuning of the system. As a starting point, use the settings suggested by the manufacturer. If the result is not satisfactory, revert to the continuous cycling method. If the viscosity is not steady on the control point, decrease the proportional gain in small steps until the viscosity is steady. Increasing the proportional gain will result in a faster but less stable viscosity control. Decreasing the proportional gain will result in a more stable viscosity control. If the viscosity control continues to oscillate or hunt, set the proportional gain back to its initial value and decrease the reset time. During this fine-tuning, the D action, if applied, should remain very small. When continued adjustment fails to bring the viscosity under control, look for erratic behavior of the process or other components. Note, if you set the proportional band, be aware that its behavior is opposite to the proportional gain. The procedure is as follows. All settings of the viscosity controller are to be zeroed out, except the proportional gain. In case of a PID controller, D action is equal to 0 seconds and I action is equal to 999 seconds. Select a small P action, such as P action equal to 4. Introduce a slight set point change for a short period of time. Restore the original set point. Increase the P action until the measured viscosity exhibits a sustained oscillation, which neither grows or decays. If necessary, repeat the last steps with a slight set point change for starting the oscillation again. The sustained oscillation will give the ultimate gain and the ultimate period. You can either measure this ultimate period with a chronometer or, if applicable, with an indicator panel. With this knowledge, the viscosity controller can be tuned in accordance with the table of settings for PI and PID controllers. If the result is not satisfactory, the fine-tuning of the viscosity system can be completed with the first method described. Manufacturers have different algorithms for electronic controllers, and these algorithms are in many cases slightly different from a real three-term controller. The process can have a different behaviour caused by different factors, such as ageing due to dirty heaters, time lag in the control system, and so on. A viscosity system is PI controlled. At sustained oscillation, there are 5 equal movements during 120 seconds, and the ultimate proportional band is equal to 38%. What are the settings on the PI controller? The proportional band is PB is equal to 2.2 multiplied by 38 equals 83.6%. Use the table of the continuous cycling method. The oscillation time is TU is equal to 120 divided by 5, which is equal to 24 seconds. The rise time is TR is equal to 24 divided by 1.2, which is equal to 20 seconds. In practice, some systems rule out the required fluctuation that is needed for the continuous cycling method.